Hello, everyone. My name is Smita, and I'm a cloud architect working in AWS Professional Services team. And today, I'm going to talk about how you can automate video editing using Amazon Rekognition. So without further ado, let's get started. So let's understand the use case first. Here, we have a full video which has many actors slash speakers. We have Leah, we have Rob, and we have Hubert talking about different things in the same video. Now, Leah wants to have just her bits extracted from the video so that she can share that on her Facebook page or maybe even on her personal website. This can be achieved by using a video editor and then manually scraping all the unwanted bits. But again, this can get quite time-consuming and quite cumbersome. So with Amazon Rekognition, which is a cloud-based software as a service, this will be just few API calls and very, very simple to achieve. So let's see how this is done. First of all, let's understand the architecture here as well. The blue color text in the diagram are the actual API calls. So I, being the user, I have uploaded the video and Leah's image in the S3 bucket as the first step. Now I will first create a collection and then request Amazon Rekognition to index Leah's face with index face API. These are the steps here, the second and the third. I'll be explaining what these APIs do when we are in the demo section. But basically what I'm doing is I'm just creating a search criteria for Amazon Rekognition. After that, in the fourth step, Amazon Rekognition accesses Leah's image from the S3 bucket and then adds the image to the collection we created. Now in the first fifth step, I call the start face search API asking Amazon Rekognition to search Leah's bits in the video. Amazon Rekognition does the search in the sixth step. This is an async search, by the way. And once the search is finished or completed, Amazon Rekognition posts the completion status to an SNS topic at step seven, which then triggers a Lambda function. A Lambda function uses the get face search API of Amazon Rekognition and then gets all the search data where Leah's face was recognized in the video. Lambda function then calls create job API of Amazon Elastic Transcoder to stitch all these scenes together so that one video is made containing only Leah's snippets. And then that video is placed in the same S3 bucket. So I hope the architecture is clear. Now what we are going to do is we are going to jump to AWS command line to see all of this in action. Just before jumping, I'm going to show you that we have just taken this video here, which is publicly available in YouTube. And all different solutions architects are talking about their life being solution architect. So I'm just going to use this video. So what I've done is I have kept Leah's image and the video here in my S3 bucket. So let me jump to the AWS command line. So the first step is that I'm going to create a collection. And I'm giving it a name, just calling my collection. So what a collection is, it contains information about faces you want to recognize or search in pictures and in videos. But at the moment, this collection is empty. So what I'm going to add is I'm going to add Leah's image to this collection. So I have this endpoint, which is index faces. And I'm going to specify Leah's image, which is kept in the S3 bucket. And I'm just going to give this a friendly name called Leah. So what index faces does is it detects faces in the input image, adds them to the specified collection, which we specified here, and in turn returns some metadata. So this is returning some metadata. Okay, so that once that is done, now our collection contains Leah's image. And now we can use our collection to search the video, which is just a very simple API call called as start face search. So what I'm doing here is I am specifying the video that I want to search, and I'm giving my collection, which has Leah's image inside it. And I'm also giving a notification channel, which is my SNS topic, topic arm, and the role arm, which I have created so that I give permission to Rekognition to post a notification to SNS. And that's it. Again, this is a asynchronous call or asynchronous search, and it search faces in that collection asynchronously and matches the faces of persons detected in that stored video. So let me do that now. So what it does is it just generates a job ID. So if we just copy this job ID and see and do a get face search call, it'll show me that the search is still being processed and it's still in progress. The time depends upon the length of the video. But again, if you just move back to our architecture diagram, just here, you know, all of this is automated. We have a Lambda function again, and I'm going to show the Lambda code in a minute. But once Amazon Rekognition pushes the notification that its job is done to the SNS, SNS would automatically trigger the Lambda function to just do the further processing. So nothing is needed from our end, but I'll show what Lambda code is there in this Lambda function. So moving to the console. So here is my Lambda function that's being called once the Rekognition sends the completion status. So what it does is it just picks the job ID that we have there, and then it calls the get face search endpoint, which gives all the results of the face search. And then what it does, it just combines them together here by using Elastic Transcoder, and then specifying what's the name of the output file that you want. And the inputs are just the scene where Leah exists. So just these things here. And that's it. So let me go and see if we have a output video created. I'll just refresh my S3 bucket because it's just going to push in the same S3 bucket. Yeah, we have it. Cool. So I'm just going to download this. I'm going to play it. So I'm just going to, so you cannot hear what Leah is saying, but I am able to hear what all of things that Leah is saying in the video, and we have only her bits in the video, and all the other parts are just scraped off. Quite cool, isn't it? Okay, so that's it for this session. Hope you liked it, and hope you can utilize the power of Amazon Rekognition to automate your video editing. Thank you so much.